Welcome back to the black screen series. We've discussed some basic uses of the black screen. If you haven't watched our last two tutorials, we'd recommend you click on the upper corner to watch them. As for today, the last tutorial for this series, we are going to bring you one more creative use of the black screen. And got so far, but in the end, it doesn't even matter. I had to fall to lose it all. But in the end, if you are interested in this, keep watching. Open up VideoProc Vlogger. Enter the project we saved last time. Let's firstly create a pendulum shown in the video. Click on this icon. Go to background and change this color to white. Hit down to go back to the main interface. Then let's drag a black solid background image to the overlay track. Enable show layout rectangle and adjust its size for making it overlap the entire frame. Then let's click on Effects. Find a circular mask. Drag it onto the effects track. Adjust the duration. Now we can see the circle in the preview window. Next, let's go to the inspector panel and find the properties. Move the slider to adjust the volume of the radius for making the circle smaller. This can save us a lot of effort when creating the motion effect later on. Then adjust the volume of the gradient to make the edges of the circle become harder. Now let's click on this image. Move this circle down on the preview window. However, now we can find that we're moving down the entire canvas rather than the single circle. No worry. Simply click on a circular mask effect and go to the inspector panel to find the scope section. Let's uncheck the option of canvas and choose the black solid color. Then we can reposition the circle and get the desired effect. Next, let's add the upper part of the pendulum. Again, let's drag the black solid color image onto the video track. Now we see two circles on the preview window. In the same way, we need to go to the inspector panel and adjust the application range for the circular mask. After that, we adjust the size and the position of this black solid color image. That can bring us a steel pendulum. Let's start by clicking on the camera icon to save a snapshot for the frame that shows the pendulum that we've made. Add it to the media library. Drag it onto the video track. Find the motion icon on the toolbar. Click on it to enter the motion editor panel. To make the pendulum swing, actually, we just need to click on Add a keyframe to add a keyframe for the first frame. Adjust the selection box. This frame shows the original state of the pendulum. Drag the playhead backward. And click on Add a keyframe to create the second keyframe. Adjust the rotation angle. Here, I enter 45 degrees. Now we can notice the preview window shows some black bars. Let's reposition the selection box. Keep moving the playhead. Hit Add a keyframe to create the third keyframe. Let's change the rotation angle to 0 degree. Meanwhile, we reposition its selection box to make it the same as that of the first keyframe. Last, let's click on Add a keyframe to add a fourth keyframe. Set -45 as the rotation angle. Then we adjust its selection box to make it align the center symmetric with that of the second keyframe. Take a preview. The movements look too stiff. This is because we didn't adjust the speed mode for the keyframe. For example, the segment between the second and the third keyframe shows a downward moving state. So we select the second keyframe. Select Smooth Speed Down number 1 as the speed mode. The segment between the third and the fourth keyframes shows the upward moving state. Here we choose Smooth Speed Up number 2 for the third keyframe. Also, let's modify the speed mode of the fourth keyframe. Now, take a preview. It looks much smoother, isn't it? Then let's adjust all keyframes. We can make this effect. Don't forget to click on Apply to get back to the main interface. Now let's firstly add a pendulum clip to overlay track number 1. Then we add prepared video clips to the video editor. Drag a video onto the video track. For editing the video in an easier way, we can click on the eyes icon of the overlay track number 1 to make it invisible in the preview window. Then let's select the video clip, hit the crop icon. Here we choose the preset 1:1 aspect ratio. Hit Apply to apply the modification. Enable Show Layout Rectangle on the main interface and reposition it to the right. Use the Split tool to get a wanted segment. Then we drag another video clip onto the overlay track. Also, we need to make some adjustments. Now we get this. After we add it and arrange all our video clips like this, hit the pendulum clip. Go to the inspector panel and apply the screen blend mode. Alright, that's the end of our black screen series. Which of these 7 uses do you love most? Or do you know more creative uses of black screen? Leave your comment to let us know. Don't forget to click the subscribe button to subscribe. We'll see you in our next tips. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye!